It's over 70 meters tall, weighing just under 1,500 tons, with more than 5 million pounds of thrust at liftoff, equal to approximately 18 747 commercial jets at full power. In a fully expendable configuration, the Falcon Heavy will be able to lift more than 63 tons of payload to low Earth orbit, or about 26 tons to a farther geosynchronous orbit. The variant of the Falcon Heavy SpaceX is testing later this month, however, will only be able to lift 8 tons. This variant compensates for the reduced payload by recovering all three core booster stages once the payload is in orbit. Assuming all goes as planned, these booster stages will all land back on specialized pads near the launch site and will subsequently be used for further launches. Currently, no other operational rocket in the world comes close in terms of capabilities to the Falcon Heavy. But how did SpaceX achieve such a feat? For that, we need to travel back in time to September 2005, when SpaceX originally announced plans to develop the Falcon 9 using the ablatively cooled Merlin 1B engine. The Falcon Heavy was simply meant to consist of three separate Falcon 9s strapped together, which would theoretically be cheaper to run and carry a much bigger payload. The project, however, faced several real-world problems, as SpaceX had still not developed a powerful enough engine for the regular Falcon 9 and had no means to recover the booster stages. It took nearly a decade for SpaceX to make an engine that met their requirements, a process that involved multiple tests of several engine variants, beginning from the early Merlin 1A to the regeneratively cooled Merlin 1C engines. At this point, early plans had been drawn up to develop an experimental demonstrator reusable rocket that could perform vertical takeoffs and landings. Two prototypes were built, and both were launched from the ground. The first was the Grasshopper test vehicle, which was about 106 feet tall, and the second was a larger, more capable Falcon 9 reusable development vehicle. The Grasshopper and FR-9 development tests were fundamental to the development of the reusable Falcon 9 rocket, which would eventually become part of the Falcon Heavy. The successful test of this reusable rocket technology coincided with the development of an upgraded Merlin 1D engine, which was nearly 1.5 times more powerful than the Merlin 1C engines that powered the first two Falcon 9 rockets. After a successful demonstration of the Merlin 1D engine in 2013, SpaceX began production of this engine variant, reaching over 100 engines manufactured in the next 2 years. The Merlin 1D engines quickly replaced their older counterparts in the Falcon 9 rockets used to send customer payloads to space. Currently, the engine is the most efficient production rocket engine in history. At this point, it was clear Elon Musk had finally found the right engine to power the Falcon Heavy, and had the reusable rocket technology needed to make it a viable launch system. SpaceX wasn't out of the woods yet though, as they would face another catastrophic setback on September 1st, 2016, which pushed the launch of the Falcon Heavy rocket to the start of this year. An anomaly which Elon Musk personally described as the most difficult and complex failure his company had been faced with in over 14 years. It involved the destruction of an Israeli satellite scheduled for orbital delivery on a Falcon 9 rocket. After several revisions and tweaks, the Falcon 9 has seen its reliability record greatly improve in the last 2 years. The Falcon Heavy, currently perched on the former Apollo 11 moon rocket launch pad, utilizes 27 Merlin 1D engines in its three-stage rocket system. Elon Musk has stated the scheduled test flight of the rocket will not carry any customer payload. Instead, we'll launch with an original Tesla Roadster playing David Bowie's Space Oddity into a billion-year elliptical orbit around Mars. Even though this particular test could fail, SpaceX and Elon Musk will eventually perfect the heavy lift system, bringing the company one step closer to their goal. Now that we understand the story behind the Falcon Heavy, I feel it's important to consider what comes next. Elon Musk teased the BFR system late last year, which he stated would replace both Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy launch vehicles, as well as the Dragon spacecraft. The system utilizes Raptor engines, which are projected to create 2 to 3 times the thrust of the Merlin 1D engine that powers the current Falcon 9 launch vehicle. The BFR system, once it passes through the testing phase sometime in the next 3 years, will be capable of deploying large satellites into orbit, as well as servicing the International Space Station. Further down the road, Musk expects the system to carry out lunar surface missions without having to produce fuel locally on the moon. This would open up the possibility of building some sort of lunar base. Finally, all of this will culminate in a manned mission to Mars, hopefully by the year 2022, which I feel is ridiculously optimistic, by the way. Beyond SpaceX, there are several other private and government-funded projects around the world committed to bringing relatively affordable and reliable space travel, not just to the rich, but for ordinary people like you and I. The path from where we are today to achieving such lofty goals will most certainly be met by persistent setbacks, but somewhere down the road, it'll all come to fruition as we take one step further in our dance with the stars. Please click the like and subscribe button below if you enjoyed the video. And if you want a heads up when I release new content, you could hit the notification button and follow my Twitter account as well. See you in the next one.